Middle Ages is the name given to the period between the 5th and the 15th centuries. In Spain, it's considered to have started with German invasion and ended with the conquest of Granada, the Muslim kingdom in Spanish land. But one of the facts that made a difference between Spain and the rest of Europe was the Muslim invasion in 711. Hispania was transformed in Andalus, and Muslims stayed in this land, south half of Spain, for all the period. Soon, Córdoba's emirate, Córdoba's caliphate, years later, a sort of kingdom independent from Damascus, was created. This period is considered a golden age for economy, military power, and also culture. Christian kings in the north fought to recover Spain. Kingdom of Austria, Leon, Navarra, Portugal, Castile, and Aragon were created and advanced southwards. At the beginning of the 11th century, caliphates split off into different titles after the civil war or fitna in Córdoba. Running away from this war, some of the magicians settled down as refugees in Zaragoza, Zaragoza. Taifa, to which Calatayud belonged, in the court of Al-Jafar, the king, and Al-Mutamar, his son, they developed a flourishing mad school. When Christian king Alfonso I conquered the city of Zaragoza, the Muslim king moved with all his mad books. Calatayud was conquered not many years later, but when this land was conquered, Muslims, Christians, and even Jewish lived in both kingdoms with relative peace, but they had to convert to each other's kingdom's faith. In Castile, 12th century, Alfonso X, the wise, succeeded his father as king and started employing Jewish, Muslim, and Christian scholars at his court to translate. Toledo's school of translations was born. In the 14th century, the Muslim kingdom was reduced to Granada. Finally, in the 15th century, Fernando and Isabel, King of Aragon and Queen of Castile, husband and wife, conquered Granada in 1492. Spanish reconquest had ended.
From an educative point of view, Calatayud has been an exceptionally rich town throughout history. Compare it with other similar cities during the Middle Ages, there was a sort of university. Pedro Zerbuna, who founded the University of Zaragoza in 16th century, is buried at Santa Maria's Church. And many other examples, it's also a remake fact that Benedict XIII of Avignon now as Papa Luna Fondi. The Studia Generis in Calatayud, a bit more than 6 centuries ago, at the beginnings of 15th century. Papa Luna ordered general studies to be founded at Santa Maria with 11 teachers to allow study civil and canonical laws, medicine, philosophy, poetry, and grammar. This way, teachers and doctors' degrees could be achieved, but we could study before carefully why this fact was something new. After a deep cultural crisis during 11th and 12th centuries, in contrast with what was happening in North Europe, Muslim schools at Córdoba and Granada were brilliant in different languages. Even when education was not free, parents used to pay for their children to be taught, and the number of persons who could neither read nor write was extremely low. Boys and girls had the same opportunities in primary schools. They used to learn to write, grammar, and math. Higher education was only possible for people who could afford it. There was no universities, and each student was free to choose whatever he considered to study. When his teacher thought he has achieved 13th level, he was having a license. Books were something really precious, and palaces used to have an important library. In Christian lands, schools belonged to the church and were mainly places at monasteries. They were considered the places where no legacy was kept. With the decline of island schools at Leonor or Toledo, for example, started preparing the basis over which study agencies and universities were built. Pedro IV of Aragon founded the university at Huesca with the same right that Tolosa's, Montpellier's, or Lerida's had, as knowledge and science were considered goods present, it was not possible to sell them. This point makes an important contrast with medieval society ideas, but studying was extremely expensive because they had to pay to be hosted, and they had to buy materials which were not as cheap. University started at the age of 14, more or less. Different faculties had different studies programs. Education was mainly oral. Studies took many years and were divided in different levels. A bachelor was the first one, and allowed working as teacher's assistant. Next level was the degree, and the highest possible was master. During 14th century, cities started to become more important, and Calatayud, who developed a city, had an important area of influence. As its population increased, educative institutions were developed. This way, study generals in cities as Salamanca, Valladolid, Lérida, Huesca, Valencia, and Calatayud started working. When Benedict XIII of Avignon had the opportunity, he established in Calatayud Studia Generalis, preceded by a school. This Studia Generalis dedicates to laws, medicine, and arts.
During the Middle Ages, we have to pay special attention to writing works made in monasteries. Until the invention of the printing press, books were copied by hand and were extremely precious possessions. Monasteries, which used to have a library, had a special place for monks that dedicated their life to copy its books and scriptures. Monks that working writing were chosen because they had a special ability when writing and spent hours and hours writing carefully. Letter, page by page, all the books that arrived to the master surfaced to write over the name of Bayum, and it was an animal food. The younger the animal, the higher the quality, for was carefully treated to be used to write over it. Parchment made with vegetable fibers was also elaborated and was used for not so important books. To write on monks' faces bedroom over their tables, which had a certain language, to make a bit more comfortable the work. And they clawed some straight lines to paste the different elements and to make it easier to write on it. With the help of thieves made with canes and cut in a special way, monks took the iron pal ink brown and the carbon ink black and started writing over the lens. When they made a mistake, they had to use scratchers to correct because it was impossible to erase. They used to illuminate pages. Illuminate was the process of decorating first letter of the page or drawing over the sides of the vellum. Illumination was made with the same techniques used to write very carefully and used different colors. Some colors were easy to find and allowed your push to know if the document was considered to have a higher value. Gold was also used to illuminate and it was glued carefully to the page. First year, the students had a talk and workshop about medieval writing to know the essence of medieval calligraphy. They could see different examples for made with medieval techniques and learn the name of the different elements. In the classes of arts for first and second year, workshop have continued making some small dogs and bookmarks with calligraphy or smatters.
Present a progressing period for math knowledge in Spain, not comparable with the rest of Europe. It's in Spain in San Millán de la Cogolla where we can find the earliest representation of numerical in the Arabic writing in Europe. It was the 10th century. Vigila describes sending the documents. Maybe he meant he was making history. In the 11th century, Gerbert Torrilla, who was later Pope Sylvester II and who stayed for 3 years, in Santa Maria de Ripoll Monastery, also traveled to Cordoba and Sevilla, getting in touch with Muslim culture. He presented to Europe some of the knowledge he got during the trip, the use of astrolabe and calculating in Arabic numerals. Due to the FINA, the Civil War, many Cordobese mathematics were refugees in Zaragoza. We could speak about Abed Allah bin Ahmed al-Sarabusti, Ali bin Ahmed bin Dad, or Ibrahim bin Idris at Tujibi from Calatayud. They introduced a Warizmi knowledge and studied geometry, astronomy and logic. Al-Mutaman, king of Zaragoza, whose father built palace of Al-Jaferia and should serve the developing of a school at his court, wrote Kitab al-Iskiman, the Book of Perfection, the greatest geometry book in Middle Ages in Europe. This book was until 1985, included the geometry of Euclides and Archimedes, but also some of the knowledge of David bin Curra and Banu Musa. It's also remarkable that they proved the Demas theorem and known in Europe until 17th century. When Zaragoza was conquered, the Muslim king had to run away with his book and established in Rueda de Jalón, where probably Miguel de Tarazona, bishop of his land, found at least some of them and ordered it to translate in Tarazona School of Translation, helped by Robert of Chester.
Hello, we are students of second level and we want to tell you how we build our adapters. First of all, we measure the wood and cut it using hatchet.
After that, we plane the edge with sandpaper.
With a drill, we made the holes and then cut the metal bars using drills.
We put the bars on the balls and finally we joined the wooden pieces with a modular.
We made the abacus working in a team and we think it was a very interesting and funny activity.
During the Middle Ages, in most of Europe, traders were used to calculate using the abacus. In Spain, due to Muslim countries, we used algorithms. Technology studies with these abacus, and first degree studies learned to calculate with them.
The abacus are made with both wire and small balls.
Studying circuit inheritance deals and fraction problems. These problems were very common in mostly mathematics books. At 4 years math classes, we were studying different ways to prove Pythagorean theorem that were already known in Middle Ages. We studied Bhaskara's and David's Vinkurra's proofs. We did the test and represented the different steps.